It's not that difficult. Let's talk about the three criteria, the core criteria that exist in the regulations. Number one, descent from a historic tribe. Now, this is the one that really gets the BIA exercise. The BIA is going on record saying, oh, no, well, we don't think those Lumbees can make it because they don't have a genealogical connection between themselves and the Chiral community from which they claim to descend. The regulations say that that determination starts, that inquiry starts in 1789. And under the regulations, we're obliged to prove the link between ourselves and the Chiral community starting in 1789. Well, there's no question that there was a Chiral community in the heart of Robeson County. We have historical records starting in 1732 that established the Chiral community on Drowning Creek, which folks is now Lumber River, and where the Lumbee people have been ever since. The historical documentation for the existence of the Chiral community, at least as early as 1783, is clear. Here's what the BIA doesn't like. We can't prove a line of genealogical descent until starting in 1790 when the first census was done. We can prove it since 1790, but there's that year gap. There's that year gap. And nothing in the 1790 census says these are Chiral Indians. It says they're clearly Indians, but it doesn't say that we're Chiral. So the BIA says, oh, close but not quite good enough. We're not sure you guys can make that connection. But what we've got is a connection from history, not genealogy, that every historian who has ever looked at it has said, I am convinced. All the way from Dr. Sturdivant, general editor of the North American Handbook of Native American, of American Indians, to every other historian since who has looked at it. And the regulations, mind you, don't say that it must be a genealogical connection. They only say proof of descent from a historic tribe. But unfortunately, in the case of Lumbee, the BIA will never accept the historical proof as sufficient. They require a genealogical connection. But every historian who has looked at us has made that connection. So we can establish that. Criteria number two, the second of the mandatory criteria. Proof of community. Let's talk about the strength of the Lumbee community folks. Even in the regulations, say that if you can prove either one of two things, that at least 50% of your folks are married to other members of your tribe, or that 50% of your folks reside in communities that are predominantly Indian, presumed existence of community. You can't marry each other and you can't live that close without there being community interaction, right? That's what one of these charts is. This chart here, this is one that we use to testify on, to make the point that under the BIA's own regulations, we far exceed the level of what they call high evidence of community on both criteria, because far in excess of 50% of our folks are married to other Lumbees, and far in excess of 50% of our folks reside in communities in Robeson and adjoining counties that are predominantly Indian. Nobody can dispute that. And this same pattern has existed from evidence from census records for as far as the census records go back. Number three, political authority. I like this one too. One thing about Lumbees, we are always, have always been a contentious lot. And our history has recorded controversy over one thing or another, but the thing about controversy is it proves political leadership. The BIA even admits that. Let me give you just a couple of my favorite examples. 1911, the Attorney General of the state of North Carolina came out with an opinion that says, well, you know what? The state established this separate school system in 1885 with the Lumbees, but we don't think that that's consistent with the rest of state law. And so we think the governor has the authority to override the Lumbee leadership in hiring decisions that are made by that Lumbee school system. And our leader said, we don't think so. They went to the state legislature 2 years later, they got it overturned by a special act of the legislature. That's political leadership. Again, shortly after World War II, did you know that in 1895, when the town of Pembroke was first incorporated, it was the only, obviously, all-Indian town in the state of North Carolina, and it was the only town when it was incorporated by special state law where the governor was authorized to appoint the mayor of the town council. Why was that? idea of allowing those Indians to elect their own leaders was intolerable to the state legislature. So from 1895 until shortly after World War II, that's the way it was. When our Indian veterans came back from World War II and took a look at this and said, this will not stand, this is not tolerable, they went to the state legislature. And it took special legislation, but the town of Pembroke got home rule, and ever since then, we've been ruled by Indian people. That's leadership. And we have examples of that throughout our history, where whenever our independence is challenged, people will rise up within our community, they will take control of the issue, and they will make sure that Lumbee independence is protected. So there you have it. Now, one final point on our history. During this period of time, during the last 125 years, when we've been on this long quest for federal recognition, and during this period of time where there were these dozen bills introduced, and the BIA was looking at us, some important historical work was being done. Starting in 1914 and right up through the 1956 Lumbee Act, the BIA would send special Indian agents down to Robson County, usually in response to one of our federal recognition bills, and sometimes in response to a direct instruction from Congress, as it did in 1914, to say, go down there and tell us if those are really Indian people. Come on, there can't be that many Indians that are in Robson and the Truck Counties. We're gonna send somebody down there and check them out. And they did this on 11 different occasions. There are 11 federal reports starting in 1914 through 1956, where special Indian agents, now not our own folks, reported back to Congress to say, yep, I saw them, they're there, and I have looked at their history, and they are clearly Indian people, and here's what I believe about their ancestry and where they came from. Some of them had different theories, but at the end of the day, they all said that we were somehow descended from the Chaw and related Siouan-speaking tribes. There is a core of history, in other words, folks, done not by us, but by the BIA itself, that documents the history and tribal existence of the Lumbee people. So the Congress itself doesn't need to be competent to make these inquiries. It can rely on the reports previously done by the BIA. It doesn't need another BIA report. One of my favorites, I just gotta tell you this, one of my favorites of these reports is one done in 1924. By a special Indian agent from, guess where, Cherokee. Had never been brought to Robson County before. Cherokee agency, Eastern Band, he was the closest one, so the BIA sent him, his name was Charles Pierce, sent Pierce over to do an investigation of the Lumbee people, and he said, you know what? There is this mythology about these folks, but they're not real Indians, but I can tell you, I saw them, and it looks to me like the majority is at least three-quarters Indian. The Eastern Band of Cherokee, that they ignore that a little bit of history, but it's just my favorite. But that's the bottom line. The history is there. There is no need for further study. And most importantly, there is no need to single out the Lumbee tribe for treatment that no other tribe has received at the hands of the United States Congress. I'm just gonna wrap it up with a quote from one of our best friends we ever had. Congressman McIntyre likes to sum up his review of Lumbee history by saying it's time for discrimination to end and recognition to begin. The history is there. The precedent is there. I can't tell you folks how long it's going to take. We all hope it's this Congress. I don't know whether it will be this Congress or not. But I can tell you this. It will happen one day. It will happen.